A new puppy means new routines. And in this video, I'm going to be sharing my puppy morning routine and the 5 things that I do every morning with a puppy to help crate training, potty training, jumping up, and everything in between. So let's just jump into this video, right? Meow. The first thing that we do every morning with a new puppy is take them potty, but it's more than just take them outside to go potty. Part of my proactive potty training process, which I'll talk about towards the end of the video, is taking my puppies out to go potty every 1 to 2 hours, sometimes more frequently, depending on their age, size, and their bladder capacity. And so when you wake up in the morning to take them potty, you really should have already taken them out about an hour or two ago before they actually told you that they needed to go. Because if you wait until they urgently need to go, like they're in the crate and they're screaming, I need to go potty, I need to go potty, and you wait until right then you're more likely to have an accident in the crate or on the way to outside. But here's the other key. When I take them outside to go potty, once they relieve themselves going 1 or 2, I don't just come right back inside right away. I often allow them, and many times I have them on a leash when we're outside just to keep more control over them wanting to go play or chew on a branch or something. Once they relieve themselves, I actually wait at least another 1 to 2 minutes just to see if they need to go again. Remember, a dog or puppy's bladder does not fully develop until they're around 6 to 9 months of age, estimated, just depending on their breed and their age and their size and their biology. And so it's very common for people to bring their puppy back inside and then they're like, oh my gosh, my dog just went potty again, even though they just went outside. And that's because they just haven't learned how to fully empty their bladder. Here's another tip. They're outside, they're going potty, and I've made sure that I had a treat jar by the back door where I take them out to go potty, and I slip a couple treats in my pocket. Sometimes I'll take a toy instead, and sometimes I'll just use verbal praise. And as they are relieving themselves, like when they're towards the end of finishing their number 1 or 2, I give them my marker QYES, which is yes, or some people use a clicker. And what that does is that is reinforcing a desired behavior that we have for our dog. Because again, dogs, especially puppies, learn by doing a behavior and completing a behavior and then getting some sort of positive reinforcement. So if after 10, 20, 30 times of them finishing going potty outside and you've rewarded them towards the end of their stream or just as they're finishing going number 2, they're gonna learn, okay, when I actually empty my bladder or when I actually finish going potty outside, I get a reward. Maybe I should go potty outside more. So this is a really good way to help with the potty training process. And then the second thing we do in the mornings with puppies is managing their environment. This is key with so much with puppy training, and it's not something I see very often at all. So you see, we come back inside from going potty. Many times, most of us are getting their breakfast ready. So while I'm getting my puppy's breakfast ready, I actually put them in a playpen. Sometimes I'll put them in their crate. And everything I talk about in this video is gonna be linked to my shop page link down below. So if you're wondering what I love and use, you can check that out after this. Then what I'm doing is I'm keeping their world small. So in the small chance that I start noticing them walking around the playpen in circles while I'm preparing their breakfast, I can go, oh, maybe they didn't relieve themselves, and quickly take them outside to go potty. Because what happens is if you come back inside in the morning, you're getting their breakfast ready, and they have free roam around the house, the likelihood of them getting into something, chewing on something, eating something they shouldn't, or going and having another accident inside is much higher. But if you, in the early stages, not their whole life, if you confine and manage their environment and really control the space that they're in, you can, one, make sure it's puppy safe. What are you doing, Wally? And 2, you can make sure that you can better keep an eye on them. So you can quickly stop what you're doing, take them outside. You're not having to run and chase after them. This is gonna be one of the fastest ways to potty train your puppy. And even better, this starts to normalize alone time and separation time away from you. Because dogs, unless you give them practice, will often struggle if they're in the same vicinity as you but can't be right next to you. So I love starting day 1, bringing that puppy home at 8 weeks old, learning that sometimes you're gonna be in a playpen or a crate or in a room that's gated off with a baby gate separate from me, even if you can see smell, or hear me. And if you normalize that now, you're going to help reduce separation and isolation anxiety. Or you can tether them to you with an adjustable hands-free leash that you can wrap around your waist, and then they can follow you. This way, you have a little bit more of an eye, keeping a little bit more of an eye on your puppy, so they have less opportunity to practice an undesired behavior. Because remember, the more your puppy has the opportunity to practice doing something, the more likely they're going to do whatever that thing is. And that could be eating socks, that could be biting at your heels, and I do have puppy biting and nipping video linked down below. That could be chewing on your furniture. So if you don't allow that behavior, they're going to be less likely to do that behavior. And my favorite adjustable hands-free leashes are linked in my shop page down below. Now, this next part of my morning routine with puppies is to enrich their meal time. And this is what I mean by that. Using their meal time as a way to add mental stimulation and or enrichment to their day. You can either do that in a very hands-off, easy way by using a slow feeder, a lick mat, a lick it buddy, a topple, or a Kong type toy where you can stuff their food in, you can even freeze it, and then they have to work to get their food out. This is really key because puppies that use their brain and have the opportunity to work for their food are going to be much more calm and much more wanting to pay attention to you and listen to you and behave because they're not going to be as bored. This is an easy way to mentally tire your dog home, Wally. Or you can work with your puppy during mealtime and have them work for their meals, asking them for basic cues. You could work on the place command, the touch cue. You could work on brain games in and around the crate to start normalizing the crate. And guys, I know that you're super busy, especially in the mornings, but even if you spend 5 minutes doing this, it will make a world of difference. And I do it every morning to start my dog off with a little bit of mental stimulation because this helps take them down a couple notches. And in addition to that, of course, I always have fresh water available. I will sometimes give them their Westpaw, which is that stuffable toy you can put their food in, or a lick mat or lick it buddy inside their crate or their playpen or on the baby gate and have them work on it while I'm getting ready for the morning for myself, making coffee, breakfast, whatever it might be. This way, again, they're practicing alone time without you. So they have the ability to practice self-soothing. And then you are positively conditioning being in the crate or the playpen and being away from you. I mean, yes, we want our dogs to be around us, but if you don't give them the opportunity to be separate from you for 5-10 minutes a day, a few times a day, every day, they are much more likely to develop an isolation or separation anxiety that you're gonna have to deal with later in their life. And trust me, I've done that. I've been there. You don't wanna be there. Also, I know this is kind of a weird background, but there's absolutely no natural light. So I'm using this lamp here, which is barely working. And that's because I'm in Southern Oregon visiting my mom, and we're surrounded by wildfires, and the smoke is literally making the skies like dark. It's insane. Anyways, the other part of this morning routine is I make sure I spend at least 2-3 minutes working on gentle, because if you do this, you're going to help stop puppy biting and puppy nipping so much faster. So what I mean by that is I take part of their meal and I'll put a little bit in my palm like this or under my thumb if they're eating a very small amount. And I offer it to them. I don't say anything at first. And I do not release the food until they only use their tongue. What this does is it teaches them that using their teeth to try to get something from you or nip at you or bite at you is not going to get them what they want. And then it also teaches them that, oh, if I'm gentle, then I get rewarded. You release their food or their treat. Do this every morning. Even if you do it with just one bite of their food every morning, after a week or two, you're going to find that they're biting and nipping tendencies is gonna drop dramatically, if not completely. If you can guess what the next, I got some treats in here, I'm doing it right here. I'm holding it under here, and only when he uses his tongue and gets his paw off of me, I'm not gonna release it until his paw's off of me, because I don't like, that's a demanding behavior that he's just started doing fairly recently. But if you can guess what my next step is in my morning routine with a puppy, then you get a lot of clout. Can you comment below? Take them outside. After any time that my puppy plays with something, eats something, drinks something, wakes up from a nap, or changes any bit of their behavior, I'm gonna take them outside or to wherever their potty, designated potty area is. Potty training works best. I have my full potty training one-step process linked here and down below. Works best if you proactively stop the accidents from happening indoors as much as possible. And the way that you do that is to take them outside to their potty area proactively so they don't have the opportunity to practice going potty inside. Oh, he's really struggling with this. I'm just gonna hold the treat here until he stops demanding it with his, yes, good boy. So you see, Yes, good boy, here you go. There you go. Real life training while I'm talking. This is like taking a lot of multiple brain, I'm gonna hold the treat while he still has his paw there. My mom's been teaching him how to do paw. Yes, so he's been offering that behavior. Good boy, good boy. Oh, yes, but I don't want him giving paw just to get what he wants. And then when we come back inside, in about 5-10 minutes after that, often I'll go right back outside because again, especially small young puppies, you want some more? They are not fully able to empty their bladder fully on the first try. Hi, buddy. Hi. Then when we come back inside, my last part of my morning process, and honestly, this can all happen within under an hour, or honestly, even in 30 minutes, and that is to do at least one brain game in or around the crate. And that's because I am a big advocate of teaching your puppy to be crate trained to keep them safe. And you don't always have to crate your dogs. I have videos linked down below on how we stopped using the crate with Wally and what age and the process for that. But while they're young, I'm a big advocate of teaching crate training. And I have my favorite crate linked down below. It's the Diggs crate. It was a game changer in crate training. Wally, as well as the Groove training tool. And one easy way to do this is just to take like a lick mat, lick it buddy, put a little bit of a supplement, maybe like bone broth that's frozen on there. Plain yogurt, plain pumpkin, no sugar, nothing added to any of these, goat whip, raw goat milk, any of these things, and putting it in or around the crate and having them work at it in there is a great brain game to help them create a positive association with being in and around the crate. Even better, you could play some tug of war in and around the crate with your puppy. That interaction with you, that attention with you is huge, huge for a puppy. And what this does is it starts to normalize being in and around the crate. Because the last thing we want to do is put our puppies in the crate only when they're going to be in there for a long time and you leave the house. We want to practice being in the crate and around the crate several times a day, especially in the beginning. Yes, yes. See, he says, Wally agrees. You're such a good boy. You're such a good boy. Or you can take like a muffin tin and you can put some of their food or some treats at the bottom of each hole, put their toys on top and they have to dig it out, which is a natural foraging behavior that mentally tires them. Do that inside the crate. Now, I would do that with the crate door open and supervised, of course. I don't like them to have things in the crate with them that they can chew, tear apart, swallow, unsupervised for safety. Now, I want to talk more about my crate training process, so click the video right here and we'll go over that together. Or if you want to see how I potty train in under 1 week, click the video right here. And I hope you have a beautiful day. Goodbye.